Back with Matt. Matt's got a motor.
Yep.
But what are we doing today?
So like on a previous video where we looked at a single phase motor controlled by this side of the circuit, the direct online starter, this time we are looking at a three phase direct online starter controlling a three phase motor.
So if I press the start button,
just start.
And then hopefully, and stop. So in that video, we looked at all the connections within the starter for a single phase direct online. We think, and it will evolve over time, that AM2 and AM2S have a three phase direct
online. Three phase online.
Okay, and you're going to be expected to connect that up.
Yeah.
And obviously then you're expected to test it. In this video, Matt's going to go through all the connections that are made in order to energize our three phase motor.
Yes. Yeah.
So we've safely isolated the circuit. So we're not live. We've got the cover off. There isn't as many conductors as I was expecting to see in here, considering it's three phase. Matt, can you go through what's going on in here?
Okay, Inga. So being three phase, it's actually looks a lot more simpler. So we've got our contacts here, number 1, 3, and 5.
Okay, yeah.
And we have just our phases 1, 2, and 3 simply coming into those contacts.
So three phase supply, L1, L2, and L3 coming in.
That's it.
And they're coming into numbers 1, 3, and 5. So that's our 400 volt supply coming in.
That's it. And then on the outgoing side, on terminals 2, 4, and 6,
okay,
are our conductors that go down to the motor.
So down the bottom here, 2, 4, and 6, they go straight down to that three phase motor. So come through the contactor, through the overload, and straight down to the motor.
That's simple. Yep. So like on the previous video where we had to loop the neutral, this time there's none of that.
Okay.
Because all three conductors go straight through everything.
So in the previous video where we looked at a single phase direct online starter, we did something quite fancy with the neutral. Recommend you look at that video. This is quite simple. We come through, the three lines at the top come in and the three lines go out at the bottom.
Okay.
Okay.
So let's carry on then from here. So we take another live feed going across to number 13, exactly the same as if it was single phase.
Did it have to be coming out of the number one terminal, or could it come out? Sorry, it didn't matter which one it comes out of.
It doesn't matter. No, it can come out of any of them.
Yes.
Again, it then comes from 13, the retaining contact, through to the start.
Okay, so this would be the button that I pressed on the front of it that was green. That's your start button. I'm taking the red one down here, was my stop. So we've come from the back, we've brought a line through to number 17.
Yep.
How is the start button connected?
So again, the start button, both 17 and 18 are connected in parallel with the retaining contacts, numbers 13 and 14.
Okay, brilliant.
So again, we have a permanent live feed here, here, and here.
Okay, brilliant.
Again, as previously, we then take a conductor from number 18, like on the diagram in the classroom where it went to the stop button.
Yes.
The stop button here is built into the overload relay.
So we're going back to that original single phase one here, which we did a drawing on. We're still coming out of 18. There is no stop button here as we did it on a drawing. It's actually built into here. Yeah. So we come out of number 18 and we go to
95. Again, 95 or 90, it doesn't matter.
Okay.
But we'll keep it in order. So we go into 95.
Okay.
Again, we come out of 96.
Yes.
And then that loops all the way back round as the same into the A1 termination of the coil.
So at the back here is the line conductor for the coil.
Yes.
So in order to magnetize that coil, we must put a neutral on the other side, and that comes out of, is that A2?
Out of A2.
So we've got a neutral there from the supply. So the three lines coming in 1, 3, and 5, and the neutral was connected at the back in the A2 terminal. By having a line and neutral across the coil, once the coil is energized, it creates a magnetic field. And is that when we hear that clunking noise and this pulls in?
And that's where you hear that clunking noise as it pulls in.
Okay.
One thing just to mention on this one. This one is it's wired up three phase.
Yes.
But it's a 240 volt coil.
Okay. Do they do a 400 volt coil then?
They also do a 400 volt coil.
Okay.
That's we'll talk about that another time. But this case, it is a 230 volt or 240 volt coil.
Okay, so that's fine. And we're happy and comfortable with that when we've got our wiring in place. We've got some other bits and bobs going on in the overload here. Is this overload interchangeable? Can I disconnect it and perhaps change it to match the rated value of the motor below?
Exactly. Yeah, exactly the same as whatever overload setting you need. This one again is 13 amps.
Yes.
But if it's only a small, I don't know, 3 kilowatt motor, you don't need a rating of 13 amps on there if it's a three phase.
Okay.
So it's exactly the same. Again, there's the little arrowhead there to adjust it with your screwdriver.
Okay.
This acts as the stop button, which is connected to the, which is linked to the stop button on the actual front cover.
Yeah.
This button here is the is the reset button. So if it does trip.
So when you say trip, we're talking about the motor below, say, was a 10 amp. Yeah. It was overloaded, that we put too much stress on the motor, it started to draw 16, 17 amps.
Yes.
It's this that trips out, yes, preventing obviously damage to the motor below.
Yeah.
Just a quick one for those people doing AM2 and AM2S. It's vitally important you set this to the specification of the job, or the rated value of the motor that's suggested in the paperwork, or moving forward, you might even have to calculate the current of the motor and set the overload according to that value. It's very important that you set it.
Yes. Okay, and Gaz, so you said about the three-phase motor setting the overload relay.
Yes.
Remember, with when we calculate the current on a three-phase,
yep,
circuit,
yes,
the equation is slightly different to the single phase circuit, so you need to check that out and make sure that you know what you're doing with that.
And that's something that you'll cover for our learners in the classroom. I'm sure the lecturer of the person who's watching this will also cover that.
Yeah.
So the connections in here are more simple than I thought they were going to be. Okay, effectively the three lines just come through. We've got a 240 volt coil, which we've got neutral on one side and the line on the other side. And we've talked about the importance of setting the overload and the reset button. I think we've covered everything we need there.
I think so, guys.
So shall we end it as we normally do?
Okay.
So I'm in England and Matt's in Australia, so he may be slightly delayed when he kicks in. So I hope this video
has been some help.